the manufacturers have decided that they're going to be using synthetic, and they recommend it in their warranty manuals. They recommend it in their owner manuals. And I think it's the tide is turning in the direction where eventually we will see synthetic oil in most of our cars. Now, why they went to it, and this is very interesting, why the manufacturers made this decision a couple of years ago is because fossil fuel oil doesn't give you quite as good gas mileage as synthetic oil. Synthetic oil will give you a fraction of a mile per gallon better. And with today's engines, the very high tolerances that they have, you know, the piston fits into the cylinder, which a much lower tolerance. The whole machine that drives our cars now operate with very tight tolerances. So if you have the synthetic oil, it will actually enhance the efficiency of the engine just slightly to give you maybe another 0.2 mile per gallon. It's not enough to compensate you for the increased cost of oil, but synthetic oil does last about twice as long. So it's a trade-off. You pay about twice as much for synthetic oil as you do fossil oil, and you have to change your oil half as frequently. So it's a wash. And the gas mileage is not consequential. Matter of fact, I think that the manufacturers got into the synthetic oil recommendation by accident. I think that they needed to squeeze out a few extra miles per gallon to meet the CAFE requirements, the federal regulations on gas mileage for the entire fleet of a manufacturer's cars on the road. So by squeezing that out and putting the synthetic oil in their cars that they sent to the EPA to do the test, the gas mileage test, the government caught them. They said, hey, you're using synthetic oil. If you use synthetic oil, your customers have to put it in the cars that you sell, and you need to recommend it in the owner's manual, because otherwise the recommended mileage, the EPA mileage that's on the window sticker, is not going to be exactly the same as what your customer can expect, although it would be within a few tenths of a mile per gallon. So they got caught with their hands in the cookie jar, you might say, and now they're recommending it. There's one interesting thing. The manufacturers will not void your warranty if you use fossil oil. I pressed Toyota on that. I said, I know you're recommending the synthetic oil. A lot of my customers don't want to use synthetic oil. They want to use fossil oil. So will you take that into consideration? Will you void their warranty in any way if they had a problem with their engine because they weren't using synthetic oil? The answer is no, they will not do that. So the manufacturers are really saying the same thing I am. Use either oil, fossil oil or synthetic. Use oil that you feel more comfortable with. A lot of times you will see oil change specials, and these are inevitably with fossil oil because it's half the price. So when you see a $14.95 oil special, you can bet that it's fossil oil. And if you've got it in your mind that you want to use synthetic oil, be sure you call the dealer before you drive all the way in there, or you call Jiffy Lube or Quick Lube or wherever you go. Anytime you see an advertisement on oil, look in the fine print. It will always say extra if you want synthetic oil.
Earl Stewart.